global warming, climate change. How do these words affect us? Although we have been hearing them since so many years, but we still think we still have very long time to go. Maybe a century, maybe 50 years, maybe not our life. It is our children who might face the consequences. But my friends, in the 21st century, things are moving very fast. What we haven't seen in the last thousands of years is happening now. Rainfall, which has not happened in 100 years, is now happening in so many centers of India. Famine, droughts, which have not happened in hundreds of years, are happening across the world. So what is going wrong? Where are we going wrong? Man being so smart, has man really failed to understand the mathematics of nature? Is defying nature, challenging nature, causing so much harm to mankind, which is irreversible? We are seeing the damage of climate change and global warming across the world. USA, Australia, China, Pakistan, and of course India. Agriculture, my friends, has the power to lift the GDP of any nation. For example, America. Look at how America has handled agriculture over the years. It has lifted the GDP of the country immensely. India has that potential. India is an agri-based country, a country where SMEs are there across the country, which contribute to the GDP of India. But India currently relies too much on the service sector, which is relying on overseas support. So agriculture is the base of Indian economy. Are we really neglecting it? Are we really compromising our future by neglecting global warming and climate change? Climate change, my friends, in 2019, if you see, 50% of India is praying for rains to come. And the rest 50% is praying for the rains to stop. Where is this going to lead us? Too much rains, a wet famine, it will take 6 months to come on. Kerala, we had this huge floods last year. This year we have in Assam, UP, Bihar, and so many parts of Gujarat now in August 2019. It is going to take 4 to 6 months for people to set up the original state of affairs which was there previous to the floods and the drought. Still in India, 50% of the regions have received less than 50% rainfall, which is not good for agriculture. Irregular distribution of rainfall is always dangerous for the yields. And if the yields are low, the crop is not going to be high. The Indian cotton crop is going to be compromised again this year if the rainfall is in a haphazard manner. It is no longer a southwest monsoon regular pattern, starting from Andaman, traveling to Kerala, then Goa, Karnataka, Maharashtra. No, it is falling anywhere and everywhere. And then when it is not falling, the rainfall is not there at all. In the same state, we may see the highest rainfall, and in the same state, some place, we will see the lowest rainfall across India. We are not aware of the losses that this will incur on the mindsets of the people, on the rural economy, which is the fundamental of growth of India. If we neglect these signals right now, we are going to compromise our own future. The government is trying hard to infuse life into businesses, into agriculture, into infrastructure, into the economy. But it has still not succeeded because the rural economy is quite weak. Mother Nature has not been favorable on India since last few years, and that is the reason there is a huge farm distress. And farm distress is leading to a reduction in the amount of consumers, directly impacting the GDP and the economy of our country. So my friends, I request all of you and I invite all of you to be aware of climate change and global warming, to encourage climate resilient agriculture in India, to promote climate resilient agriculture in India, accept farmer as your supply base, as part of a supply chain, and have a sympathetic vision towards him. India can grow very far. There is a huge vacuum across the globe, and India can fill that space very conveniently. But we need to understand our strength, our weaknesses. Our strength lies in our agriculture. Our strength lies in our SME structure. And if we can support that, I don't see any reason that anything can stop India. So climate change and global warming are no longer words in the textbook. They are very much part of our life and our future depends on it. Thank you, my friend. This is Manish Daga from COTTONGURU.